From the edge of Music City, live from Liberty Hall in the historic factory in Franklin, Music City Roots is on the air. We'd like to welcome our live audience listening in on Hippie Radio, watching on the web, best of all, right here in person. How's everybody doing out there? Oh, you're ready for some great music. Thanks for joining us for a very special edition of Music City Roots. It's that time of the year. Fall beginning to nip the air, and the Americana Music Association Convention and Festival has come to town. Tonight, we have a spectacular AMA showcase lineup featuring some iconic figures from the music we love so much. Speaking of icons, I'm about to introduce one. Nobody knows more about Americana than our musical host. He's the master of ceremonies once again at last night's Americana Honors and Awards. Didn't he do a great job? Yeah, down at the Ryman Auditorium. But we get to be with him every week, and it's just a joy and a pleasure. He says, I never say anything good about him. He is wrong. I just did. And that's it. Say hello to Grammy-winning singer, songwriter, and all-round great guy, Jim Lauderdale.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Well, you know, I think I'll kick things off with a tune I wrote with my friend Robert Hunter, one of my favorite songwriters.
Well, heard your farmer say, excuse me, please. Those were the days, but so are these. Pull over park, turn off the key. Let's go walking, just to you and me. Sometimes, always, sometimes, never. Been that way damn near forever. Promises that don't deliver. Let's set down the patchwork river. Patchwork river, patchwork river. Me and Joe Farmer walk down together. Talk about hopes, talk about schemes. Talk about salvaging some of our dreams. Heard your farmer say, if I may, serve you breakfast from a supper tray. Got no eggs, but I saved some shell. Lost the clapper, but I found the bell. This man's father is that man's son. Brothers or sisters, has he none? Looks in the shaving glass, what's he see? Looks like mama, but he talks like me. Patchwork river, patchwork river. Me and Joe Farmer walk down together. Tell a few jokes at our own expense about life on the other side of the fence. Well, heard Joe Farmer say, don't be shy. Same rules apply as in days gone by. Styles may vary and the lingo bend. What it all boils down to in the end. Pay your dues and take your chance. Don't mistake hunger for romance. Forgiveness is nifty, but enough's enough. When they keep on pulling that same old stuff. Patchwork river, patchwork river. Me and Joe Farmer walk down together. Talk about wealth and the worry it brings. Lack of satisfaction, other things. Vision is simple by moonlight. Everything black and white. No colors to construe. Just a range of black and blue. Softer tones, fewer voices. Freedom from too many choices. A newborn moon's a silver sliver. Gleaming on a patchwork river. Well, heard your farmer say, just in case you feel like cutting right to the chase, I would never stand in your way. There's just one thing I wanna say. What you do for love alone will last. The rest just clutters up your past. But if you don't know that much by now, you're never gonna learn it anyhow. Patchwork river, patchwork river. Me and Joe Farmer walk down together. talk about hopes, talk about schemes, talk about salvaging some of our dreams. Patchwork river flowing with song, patchwork clouds just drifting along. Talk about hopes, talk about schemes, talk about salvaging some of our dreams.
Thanks so much, everybody. And welcome to Music City Roots, live from the factory here in Franklin, Tennessee. And who's come from out of town to be a part of the Americana? All right, well, welcome. And congratulations to all the winners last night. Let's hear it for them. And everybody that performed, everybody that got nominated. And, you know, all the festivities are underway. You know, every night there's something great going on. And so we encourage you to go out and see, after the show, after this show, though, go out and see them. So, well, let's get started. Now, the guys up here, you know, this is a radio show at the end of the day, and you can't have a proper Nashville radio show without a podium and a qualified announcer, and we have the best there is, Grand Ole Opry veteran Keith Bilbrey.
Thank you, thank you. I like that song.
Thank you, Keith.
That, you know, you and Robert Hunter just create these images in my mind when you write us. It's amazing. I can just see that river with all the passwords in it flowing down the internet stream. Password river. That's
no, Keith,
that's
it's
really
patch,
good.
Patch. Not oh. Pat, pass. But
oh.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. I thought you said password.
That's all right. That's okay. I know
the,
my
the lyrics are in the booklet.
I was mumbling.
Like
I know.
A high tech ode to internet. I'm sorry.
Well, anyway, Keith Bilbrey. Let's hear it for him again. He's and over in the Griffin Technology chat room is the guy who will tell us about tonight's lineup and help us get to know the artists a bit between the sets. And he's a longtime music writer, author of Air Castle of the South, and our own roots journavangelist, Mr. Craig Havighurst.
Right. Yeah. I'm both. No objectivity here. This is all great. Thanks, Jim.
Thank
hey, everybody. Welcome, and welcome to folks who are from out of town and out of the country for Americana, favorite time of year. Just an amazing density of talent, and the ramble around, get your wristband, and go see shows. Thank you. As always, we are on the air live. We are a radio show, and we are on the air live locally here in Nashville on Hippie Radio, 94.5
yeah.
FM. The team is here. Welcome, to guys. We so appreciate it. Hey, Barb. Hey, Rob. Oh, good to see ya. We also want to say thanks to Sound Image because they're the ones responsible for this gorgeous sound here in the hall, these speakers and the guys on the board, and they do this every week. Thanks to Real Water, they keep us hydrated. Thanks to Sapphire Restaurant, Tom Morales and his team have delicious food down there. If you didn't stop for dinner before, they got some great fare over and concessions back there, including the now famous Nashville Jam and biscuits. And a great, so that's a great taste, chance to get a taste of one of our show's sponsor. We'll have the Nashville Jam at the end of the show. Stoveworks Restaurant, just down the hall here. We thank them. They fix our crew lunch, and that we appreciate that. That keeps them going all day. And a little congratulations to our own team member, Ashley Manson, has taken her MCAT, so good luck to you. And Ashley Jean Trott got nominated for an IBMA Momentum Award. We think that's pretty cool. We'll find out if she won 2 weeks hence in Raleigh, North Carolina, where some of us are going to head out. So on tap in the Blackstone Brewery lineup tonight, we're going to get started in an acoustic vein. We got two solo artists, one of which Jim will tell you about. The other is coming up soon. Ruthie Foster is here from Austin, Texas, making her Music City Roots debut. So excited. Back in business after a little bit of time off, the wonderful Canadian folk band, The Ducks, are here. That's all those crazy drums are part of the great act, The Ducks. And of course, I know a lot of you come to see our final set. We're going to extended set from the original lineup of that great band, BR549.
Yes, sir.
Country music. Yes, sir. So let's go.
All right, folks. Our first guest is one of the nation's master of blues and folk. A true original as a songwriter and guitarist. Growing up in New Orleans, he was first inspired by Lightnin' Hopkins. Then his wide search for a personal twist on tradition led to an acclaimed performing career and beloved songs recorded by others, including Bonnie Raitt and Diana Krall. And just a personal note here, one of my career highlights was when I got to open up for him at the Bottom Line several years ago in New York. And he just couldn't have been a nicer guy, and I'm a huge fan. Well, we couldn't be prouder to welcome to Music City Roots the incomparable Chris Smither.
Hey, folks. Good to see you. I'm going to open up with a song called Open Up. Can't you see? I can't explain. I'm a little like a link of chain, a ring around another, running in and out again. Fly me on a cat line, smiling like a gold mine. I don't need to be blamed. Go to the end. Thank you. morning rain, make it so. We get a little in the afternoon to hold me like a mother. Hang me on the evening moon, send me on a low one, show me how to go one more. And if I find it this time, we go to the end, take it along for the
Thank you. Thank you so much. All right, I'll do you here. Here's a song I've been playing for a while. This is a very New Orleans flavored song. The chorus to this song comes from the street song of the fruit and vegetable man that used to come down the street that I grew up on in New Orleans. He would sing at the top of his lungs about what he had on the truck. You could hear him coming, you know, blocks down the street. I just did a big double CD, a retrospective CD, 50-year retro. I've been writing the songs for 50 years. It's amazing. It's amazing what happens if you keep getting up in the morning. And on this one, we recorded all these songs, this whole retrospective down in New Orleans. And for this one and a couple of others, we had the great Alan Toussaint came in to play piano. You know I don't know much, but I knew less and I was heartbroken for the first time. I was drowning in my tears and I went looking for a lifeline. I was just trying to find some comfort, a simple tender touch. I was searching for some little cure that would not cost too much. And I could hear that produce wagon on the street. I could hear that farmer singing as I cried myself to sleep. I got banana, watermelon, peaches by the pound, sweet corn, merlotong, no better than in town. I got okra, enough
to choke your beans of every kind. If hungry is what's eating you, I'll sell you peace of mind. But this ain't what you came to hear me say. The cheapest thrills our love were teaching me to live. Yeah, but nothing seemed to last or see me through. Nothing but that little song I still sing to you. I got banana, watermelon, peaches by the pound. Sweet corn, mighty tongue, no better than in town. I got old choke your beans of every kind. If hungry is what's eating you, I'll sell you peace of mind. But this ain't what you came to hear me say. I hate to disappoint you, but I got no love today. I got no love today. I got no clever. For your own good, I'll tell you what's right before your eyes. Intelligence is no defense against what this implies. Cause in the end, no one will sell you what you need. You can't buy it off the shelf. You got to grow it from the seed. Cause I got banana, watermelon, peaches by the pound. Sweet corn, mighty tongue, more better than in town. And I got okra, yeah, enough to choke your beans of every kind. If hungry is what's eating you, I'll sell you peace of mind. But this ain't what you came to hear me say. I hate to disappoint you, but I'm gonna disappoint you. I got no love today. I got no love today. Fresh out.
Thank you. All right. Well, here's a miserable little blues for you. Take a little slow resentment and an ounce of small regret.
half a cup of wounded pride that hurts inside and has not faded yet. Add a pinch of passion and a double shot of booze. When your self-respect is crashing, you can drink it up and you can cash in on the blues. Say I ain't surprised, my sense of humor's paralyzed by the blue. But the preacher teaches patience in the ancient sense, and it stretches out for years. I can't stand to listen, I can't see beyond this glistening of tears. It's never nice to hear advice you know you'll never use. Spirit might be willing, but the flesh is out there and it's shilling for the blues. For the blues. No, it's never nice to hear advice you know you'll never use. The spirit might be willing, but the flesh is out there. Still shilling for the blue. Well, thank you, folks. Thanks for being here. It's a pleasure to play for you. This is called Seem So Real. up and down, never mind the level. If down were up, you couldn't get much higher. Digging deep, working with a shovel, trying to set your soul on fire. Trying to set your soul on fire. But it don't burn. These easy things are hard to learn. It don't burn. These easy things are hard to learn. Night and day, always at the ready. Working hard to find that easy line. What you say, we just try to keep it steady. Easy work is hard to find. Easy work is hard to find. Keep your head low. What they don't see, they'll never know. Just keep your head low. What they don't see, they'll never know.
The great Chris Smither. Yeah. Chris Smithers, everybody. Thank you so much. Woo. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there. Well, folks, on your way in, you may have noticed the new Roots Radio studio just outside the front doors. And you can download the free Roots Radio app and hear live cuts from Music City Roots 24/7. Stop in after the show, show that you have the app, and get any of my CDs at the regular price. So just stop on in.
It's quite a deal.
What's that?
That's quite a deal.
That's right.
And they're valued at twice the price.
I know it.
You said I never said anything good about you. I'm saying good things about you today.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I think there's something wrong with the monitors here. He's been complimenting me, it sounds like. Anyway.
All right. Well, let's talk about French's boots. I'm telling you what, I love boots. Been loving them since I was a kid. Got them on right now. Congratulations to French's Boots, now with 14 stores here in Tennessee. If you're in the house tonight, you can see a wonderful display of their boots back there. I kind of got to stay away from them because I'll end up buying them all. And They have some beautiful bootwear up in Spotser Village. Check it out. Find French's here in Franklin, just a few blocks from the square, in downtown Nashville next to the Wild Horse Saloon, and all across Tennessee. And you'll also find the best prices on boots anywhere. Now, if you go down to the 2nd Avenue store, you're just not going to believe the number of boots that are in that store, and all kinds of Western wear, all sorts of things. So check it out. It's a beautiful, beautiful store right there on 2nd Avenue. By the way, the folks in the audience are reading programs on an office equipment provided by Digitech. If you need copiers, printers, or serious office machinery, you can find them at digitechllc.com. Now, we're going to head on over to the Griffin Technology chat room. They're all about communication, and so is our friend Craig Havokhurst with some old friends.
Yeah, try to be. Thank you, Keith. Folks from BR549, Smiling Jay McDowell and Gary Bennett, please welcome them. Oh, no, I know. This is great. So in some way, the story goes that we may have the guys in Old Crow Medicine Show to thank for the first of the reunion shows that led you here to be here tonight. And what was the story?
Well, anyway, of course, those guys have had some pretty good success in the last few years, and they're playing regular and playing some big shows. And we knew those guys from, I guess, like the, probably from being around the Opry, mostly is where I remember those guys. But they were out on the sidewalk busking when we would walk into the Opry. And those guys were, you could see it in their eyes and you could hear it in their voices. They were gonna do something. And they've had some good luck, and they were nice enough to think of us last summer and invite us to play at Fontenelle and have a little show.
It can't have been the first time y'all have been asked to do something like that.
Was it?
I mean,
it was the first time we were tempted.
First time we were tempted, right? And was it, so there was some logistics. People didn't all live in Nashville anymore, did they?
Yeah. Let's see, had you moved away by then? You were still here. But Shaw, the drummer, was in Phoenix. Yeah. So yeah, we had to get him back. Old Crow, they were, you know, we were happy to get together with them and play, and it was a good time. It was easy here right in town. So.
And was it easy to find the groove again? I mean, you knew the songs, but...
Yeah, I was nervous that it would be tricky, but no problem.
So Jay and I had a great talk this week that went on Hippie last night about the days at Roberts, and people have to be reminded that it was less than 2 years with the 6 nights a week gig down there, and then... The offers came in, and there was a chance to get signed and travel. And I'm interested in that, what you said about how you realized then that you'd not played outside Roberts. You did. Right. You had to go and face new audiences and new venues at a time when the spotlight was on you in a big way. So talk about that phase, those first weeks and months.
Right. I was nervous. I personally was nervous about the transition. I think we all felt it, too, because we had a good thing going downtown, and we knew we were leaving that. Ironically, to sell a record called Live from Roberts, we had to leave and play everywhere else. So then we find ourselves in these different situations, and it's a fragile thing being in a band, but we all leaned on each other, and everybody stepped up, and we knew.
And the audience just responded.
Yeah. And we just did our thing. At first, I remember us talking about, like, okay, we're playing some blues festival. How are we going to change what we do? And then we learned right away, don't change what we do. Just do what we do. It translates, whether it's a rock crowd or a country crowd or whatever.
Right. Gary, you and Chuck Mead, as you all will see later, have a real dynamic. You're almost co-frontmen in this band. A lot of vocals together, a lot of back and forth with singing. How did you guys find that chemistry? What was the stage where you did that?
I was at Roberts, for sure. My first time I heard Chuck, I was walking to my truck from Roberts, and I walked by Tootsie's, and I heard a guy doing a Johnny Horton song in there. Now, that's different. You see, most people our age, a lot of people can do a million Hank Williams songs, but Johnny Horton was kind of my guy, and I thought, wow, that's cool. So I went in and listened a little bit, and he went on a break, and we talked a little bit, and I got up and played a song. He was just playing a solo, I think him and a drummer, and we talked about getting together and playing, and about 2 weeks later, my guitar player got sick. So I called Chuck, and he came down. And the very first night, what it was that we both grew up. Our mom and dads were the same age. We grew up on their era of country music and around the house. Right. So we knew all the music, and the very first night we had harmonies. And we couldn't do originals the first night because we didn't know each other's songs, but all those old country cover songs, we knew how those went. And it just really, my repertoire combined with his, and then all these guys got involved, and it just built and built, you know, just...
I've heard you and he would connect together and each sit in on each other's shifts for a total of as many as 8 hours of music.
Sometimes, at very first. Well, yeah, but the other thing that was a harsh reality of the time is that we were all living off of tips. Yeah. And if you can play, you know, at least every day down there for a four-hour shift on Broadway, you might make enough. If you could play 2 4-hour shifts, you're going to probably be all right. Back then, it was a lot more lean as far as tourist traffic.
Oh, yeah. We got to remind everybody that Lower Broadway, when this got started, was a pretty seedy place. The Ryman had just been renovated against maybe all common sense, because there was not tourists downtown or businesses or hotels or restaurants, let alone what is has happened today. Just to wrap up, are you guys gratified by how you, when you see Lower Broadway, busy today? Mixed feelings or all?
Mixed feelings, I guess. I think as far as I go, I feel lucky that we had it the way it was, because it was, I think that was probably be the last time it'll ever be that amount of freedom. And there was nothing going on, so that meant anything could go on. And now there's a lot of people are sort of trying to keep their gigs, and I don't know, it's just a lot different, but.
Ditto.
Yeah, ditto.
I do like going down there, though.
Well, thanks for being here. Y'all played Musicians Hall of Fame yesterday, and may there be at least a few more of these. This is great. We're looking forward to it. BR549's coming back to the stage, everybody. Thanks, Gary. Thank you, Jay.
Thanks, Greg.
Let's have a little Vietti chili song with Travis Stinson and friends.
All right. I got my good friends from Denver, Jimbo Darvill and Sweet Tea. We're filling in for Allie Sutton. Vietti chili, Vietti chili. Tasty, hearty, read that label. Put some on your dinner table. Watch the smiles go around Vietti chili. Jimbo Darvill.
Hey, Jimbo Darvill here with Sweet Tea and Travis Stinson. On behalf of Allie Sutton, reminding y'all to pull that tab and feel the love.
Vietti chili, Vietti chili. Chili mac or topped with cheddar. Louisiana's even better. Watch the smiles go around Vietti chili. Vietti chili.
Thanks, Sweet Tea and Jimbo. Travis Stinson, everybody. Well, folks, the first thing you notice about our next guest here tonight is her magnificent voice. It's powerful and polished, but also down home and steeped in the blues and gospel. That voice has won a number of awards in her adopted hometown of Austin, Texas, and she's an exceptional songwriter and performer as well. Her very new album is entitled Promise of a Brand New Day. We're so excited she's part of our Americana Showcase. Please welcome Ruthie Foster.
Hello, hello. It's so nice to finally get the invite. Hey, thank you. About a little bit of blues, huh? Trying to find a new home, trying to write a new song, trying to find a rhythm that'll help me. Oh, when I get through it, oh, I keep singing the blues. Everybody's saying, you gotta get away and go deal with the real stuff. But I don't know if it's gonna be true enough. Oh, I keep singing the blues. Oh, you know I'm just passing on, singing the same old songs. Sometimes it feels so right and I don't feel away. I'm staring at the mirror, oh, singing the blues.
a little upbeat reggae, and I can lift and appreciate, but I'd rather be home. Yeah. Oh, singing the blues. Well, I've been in and out of soul, even rock and roll, but a little Bobby Blue Bland never, never gets old. And I realize, oh, I gotta hear me some blues. Yeah, you know I'm just passing on, singing the same old songs. Sometimes it feels so right and I don't feel all alone. But when the music fades and the crowd drives away, I'm staring at the mirror. Oh, singing the blues. Oh, I'm staring at the mirror. Singing the blues. Same old songs. Sometimes it feels so right and I don't feel all alone. When the music fades and the crowd drives away, I'm staring at the mirror, singing the blues. Yeah, I'm staring at the mirror. Oh, singing the blues, yeah. Still singing the blues, yeah. So singing the blues.
Yeah.
Woo!
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's all right. That felt good for me. I don't know why I'm trying to play guitar after Chris Smith. I don't know. Maybe I'll go into a soul yodel or something. No. Yeah. my soul's run away. It left me waiting here, trying to suffer on my own.
Grab your hip and go, woo! All right, I had to shake that one out. All right, we're good, we're good. Woo! Oh, I'm feeling good tonight. Sounds like you are too. So yeah, I've got this new CD out and I wanna do something I wrote especially for it. I grew up with a lot of blues and soul and gospel in the house, and Sam Cooke was one of my favorites. Yeah, my mama, she made me dust this stereo, you know, the console stereos, remember those? You save green stamps up to get these things, you remember green stamps, S&H green stamps, come on. Woo! I think every appliance in our house was from green stamps. But I had to dust that thing every Saturday, and I made sure I got my dusting done in time for Soul Train. I had my priorities. But I did love me some Sam Cooke, and my mother had lots of Sam Cooke records, so I wrote this with him in mind. My kind of lover. Love ever known, yeah.
yes, I am. And I'm guided my way in the truest direction. You can count on me and my righteous affection. You wanna be mine, oh mine, oh mine. Yeah, you wanna be my kind of lover, baby. You wanna be my kind of lover, baby. My kind of lover, baby. My kind of lover. All mine, all mine, all mine. You wanna be all mine, all mine, all mine, all mine.
Good on you, helping me keep the beats. Oh, man. You guys are wonderful. I can stay here all night, but I know I can't. All right, I got one more tune? Yeah, one more tune. Okay. Well, let's see. My papa was a... That's my granddaddy. My papa, he was a huge fan of a cappella. He called it a cappella. Said, baby, you know, I love it when you play the guitar for me. And he loved country music. And so I grew up listening to a whole lot of country. And Hee Haw was one of his favorite TV shows. I know. Of all TV shows. But it was fun for him. And it was fun to watch it with my papa. He thought the jokes were great. And he thought the fashion was in. You know, it's like, see? That's what he wore every day. And so we had a good time connecting when it came to any kind of music, but he did like his country music and he did love a cappella. So I would sing for my granddaddy under this old tree, this old live oak tree. That's where he had his church. He wouldn't go to church with us, but he'd be sitting there when we got back having his fellowship. Just sitting there with his legs crossed and his rolled up cigarette. Yeah, he rolled his own cigarettes. So. It took him forever to do that, too. It was just like watching art, you know, watching my papa. But papa, I want to send this one out to him. This is a title song for Promise of a Brand New Day, my new CD. I'm going to move it up. One more. I got hope, no light, got pain, got strife, don't need nobody tell you how to live your life. Sometimes you hurt so down you can't work. I couldn't see a better way. Keep trusting one more day. My heart, my mind is open wide. Forgiveness, see me through. I'm free. Are you? Friendships come and they go. Lesson learned and so. Even now I say, one day break at a time, cause life heals and life lives and time will reveal a brand new day. You know, life heals and life gives and time will reveal a brand new day. You might stumble along the way, knocked down, but that's okay. Meanwhile, I say, follow the promise of a brand new day. Uh-huh, ooh, uh-huh, ooh. Can you help me out? Uh-huh, ooh, uh-huh. Testify now. Ooh, uh-huh, ooh, uh-huh. Uh-huh, yeah. might sound untrue, but this song's for you. Let come what may, follow the promise of a brand new day, 'cause love heals and love lives and time will reveal a brand new day. You know, love heals and love gives and time will reveal a brand new day.
Ruthie Foster. Woo. Thank you so much.
Wow.
Ruthie Foster, everybody. Wow. Man, she put the scald on it, Keith.
That's a serious scald right there.
Boy, I'll tell you what. Well, Keith.
Yes,
you know, we've spent all season finding creative ways to showcase Kirkland's products and to get people to sign up for the Dream Room giveaway.
You are exactly right, Jim. We've talked about rugs, lanterns, fake family members, ice buckets, and even your modeling photo. I love that. No. You're safe tonight.
Well, oh boy, it's been real fun, but the fun has to end sometime.
That's right, Jim. This is the last week to sign up for Kirkland's $1,000 Dream Room giveaway at kirklands.com/roots. We'll announce the winner of the giveaway next Wednesday, September 24th. That's going to be a big night. Go to kirklands.com/roots and make sure you get signed up. You're listening to Music City Roots on Nashville's Hippie Radio, WHPY, Bellevue, Nashville. 94.5 on your FM dial. Music and fun for hippies of all ages. Their dune buggy is parked right over there. They switched places tonight with the Leaf. So it's right here in Liberty Hall, and that, my friends, is Hippie. And, of course, we're broadcasting live from our new home inside the historic factory at Franklin at the intersection of Franklin Road and Liberty Pike, just 15 miles from Nashville, 6 blocks from downtown Franklin. Come visit the Roots Radio studio and store right here at the factory in Franklin. We have some hippies sitting over there, don't we? There's Hippie Barb. What happened to Hippie Rob and his mom and his sister? Where'd they go? I don't know. Yeah, Gary Talley's here from the Box Tops. Good to see you. Yeah, we're having a big old time. What if getting a home loan was like borrowing a cup of sugar or turning on the hippie radio? Well, at Ascend Federal Credit Union, a mortgage is a recipe that can't wait to share with you. Ascend offers a wide variety of mortgage and home equity products with competitive rates and reasonable terms, whether you apply online or at a local financial center. Ascend's always keeping your best interest at heart. Whether you're buying your first home, refinancing for a better rate, or refunding your favorite home, Ascend will guide you through every step of the process. Invite Ascend into your search for a home loan and see what's possible. To begin your application, well, it's easy. Check the latest rates or go to a complete list of mortgage and home equity products. Visit AscendFCU.org, and you can also visit your nearest Ascend Financial Center or call 800-342-3086. Experience personal financial service that aims higher. Ascend Federal Credit Union, raising possibilities. An equal housing lender, Ascend is federally insured by the NCUA. Membership is limited. By the way, thanks to Griffin Technology for the phone charging station up in Sponsor Village. Appreciate that very much. Craig's all recharged, and he's over in the chat room. What's going on?
The talent in the chat room now is a little intimidating. Chris Smither, Ruthie Foster, put your hands together for him, folks. Yo. We started off with solo artists, but no lack of energy. My gosh. So y'all know each other a little bit from...
Years.
Folk and blues circles. Yeah, good. Well, it's so good to have you both. You represent two sides, two you know, facets of the many faceted thing that is the blues and soul and gospel music in this country. What the blues, subject of hundreds and hundreds of books, and there was a symposium yesterday about Mississippi and music that on one hand we cherish what is fixed in on recordings and sort of scriptural songs that are, you know, but the power to keep reinterpreting this stuff and find your own way in it. I'd just love for each of you to kind of address what the blues means to you and how you've tried to find your own voice in it. You got the microphone,
sure,
Chris.
Yeah. Well, you know, I got into blues. I wasn't really sure I even understood what it was, but I had I've been playing guitars since I was 9 years old, and I was going to school in my first year of college in Mexico City, and I was rooming with a guy from Texas, and he loved the way I played the guitar, but he gave me a Lightnin' Hopkins record. He says, "Here, check this out," you know. And so it took me about a week to figure out which guy he wanted me to listen to when I realized there was only one guy playing. And then, you know, I didn't even think about it as blues. You know, what I heard when I listened to that record compulsively, and what I heard was somebody who had figured out how to play rock and roll by himself.
Very nice to put.
And I thought, that's for me. Now I don't have to join a band. Now I don't have to let anybody know how little I know about music.
And Ruthie, you said there was a lot of music, country too, but the blues specifically, what does it play a role in your life?
You know, I grew up with a lot of gospel, like I mentioned, but my dad loved the blues, and he would make these tapes for me, where he had one tape recorder going and another tape recorder going. So he would pop the button on like Lightnin' Hopkins, and then and all you could hear was him in the kitchen going, "Whoa, that's a good one, baby. You should listen to that one." And you know, he's just trying to DJ through the entire thing. And so it was hard to hear what was going on, but I got the feeling that it was something I needed to know. And so, you know, I got into blues as a singer in college, because, you know, that was a thing to do. I was going to school in Waco, Texas, and so it was. I wanted to be in a blues band just to kind of, you know, get my voice, find my voice. But over the years, you know, it's been about finding out that I have something to say, and it's about living it, and it's about knowing that, you know, when you're not in a good place, you're not the only person who's been there.
Right. Ruthie, you grew up, was it a fairly rural place you grew up in, Texas?
Yeah, I grew up in Gauz, right in the middle of Texas.
Right. And was the fact that all this music was around just a unique feature of your family, or would you say it was part of the community too?
It was definitely part of the community. Yeah, definitely. But blues is just so close to gospel for me, because I learned the piano first. So.
Okay.
Yeah, so to me, it's just kind of just, you know, you add a seventh, and the rest is about groove.
And you went to Austin to get established as a musician? Is that accurate to say?
I've been all over trying to get established as a musician. Still working on that. Yeah, but Austin is my home now. Yeah.
Right. And you were in New Orleans in your formative years, but you went to, was Boston the place that you went to kind of get going in a career? Was that motivation?
I was in Boston. I was in New Orleans until I was almost 23, you know, the thing about New Orleans was it wasn't much of a guitar town, and it wasn't a blues town. I mean, it was all horns and keyboards, you know, and people would listen to what I was trying to do, and they'd say, "Well, that's quaint, Chris. What are you going to do for a living?"
Wow, no kid. And when you got to Boston, did it feel a little square?
No, actually, it didn't. You know, it felt good to me, because my father was a university professor.
Okay.
And so, you know, Boston is just one enormous campus.
I mean, right.
It's like 500 different colleges.
How'd the folk revival affect what you did?
Oh, that's what I went up for, you know. It was in the early days. That was in the middle of the 60s. And, you know, I was 22 years old. And, you know, Dylan Baez, Jim Queskin Jug Band, plus all these beautiful Chicago blues guys that you could go listen to at the Club 47 for a dollar and a half. You could hear Howlin' Wolf.
Oh, right.
You know, you could hear Muddy Waters. You could hear, you know, Junior Wells, you know, Buddy Guy.
There's
amazing.
A documentary screening this week about Club 47. I don't know if it was today, but check your schedules in case it is, because that's one of the great clubs, a great story.
Yeah.
So you've just released this Still on the Levee compilation. And to be clear, it's not a not a best of recordings. You re-recorded songs that meant a lot to you through the years, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, and how did it feel to revisit some of that older material?
Well, it was strange at first. Some of them I had to relearn. Some of them I hadn't even listened to for 20 years, wow. Some of these songs. And I would sit there and I would listen to my early records and I would say, what is that kid doing? I didn't even remember, you know, but gradually it would come back to me. And then my producer was very happy when I couldn't remember anything about it. And he would just say, okay, just treat it as if somebody gave you this song.
Right.
How would you do it now? You know, and there's a couple of them that are total departures from the way they were in the beginning. And but it was nice, you know, I'd never had stopped to look at, because, you know, all through these years, I've just gone day to day, record to record.
Right.
You know, I just kept my mind focused on what's right now. And Goody, my producer, said, he kept saying, don't you want to look at the whole thing? You've been doing this, you know, mm-hmm. for 5 decades. Don't you want to look at it?
Oh, we're so glad to have a retrospective. And Ruthie's, of course, just mentioned her CD, Promise of a Brand New Day is New. How many is this in your catalog now? About nine.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Great. And just before we go, anything to say about this record to just give people a little feeling for what flavor of you this is?
It's soul. It's like Rootsy soul for me. And Michelle Indigo Cello actually.
I'm glad you said it. I was going to.
Indigo Cello.
What an interesting producer. And there's I found a piece pretty quickly, an article interviewed. Mm-hmm. With you about working with her, and she's a fat, you know, global influence, bass player, songwriter, and a mystic. I think she's
very much so.
Something else,
a storyteller, and she helped me put these songs together, so it does tell a story. Mm-hmm. This particular album, yeah.
Oh, great stuff! Wish we had more time. It's so good to talk to you and hear you guys play. Ruthie Foster, Chris Smither, thank you so much. Let's get on with the music.
All right. With influences from at least 4 different continents, the band taking the stage right now has carved out a special niche in the global music scene. But you can also clearly hear the heart of their home in Winnipeg, Canada. Now, fortunately, they've migrated all over North America since launching in 2002, bringing passionate, funky folk to audiences far and wide. They've just released Beyond the Blue on Compass Records, and it's a thrill to welcome them back to the roots, the Ducks.
Me being young and foolish, man, led me astray. took an old Jaybird 18 years, fly from home to home.
Difficulties mean I can talk. We're so thrilled to be here tonight. We've been hearing so much about Music City Roots. We love Nashville. It's great to be back. And this is just a profound honor. Following Ruthie Foster as a singer is a cruel and unusual form of torture. But I recall a time we were playing at the Vancouver Folk Music Festival years ago, and Odetta was playing, and we were following her. And I was walking up the steps to the stage, and she was coming off, and she said, "How you doing, honey?" And I said, "Well, I'd be a lot better if I didn't have to go and sing after you." And she goes, "Oh, honey, you just go out there and you give them heaven. And if that don't work, you give them hell." I was like, "Okay, I think I'll be good now." So those words go through my mind in moments like this. We have a brand new record that came out on Compass Records in Nashville on June 24th. And thank you. That last song's on there. We learned it from Mike Seeger. It's called Banjo Roustabout. And we'd like to play the title track from the new record now. This one's by the phenomenal Beth Nielsen Chapman, and it's called Beyond the Blue. Thank you.
About a year old, my grandmother put some money away for me to go to college, and when I was 18, I received that money, and I did in fact follow her wishes. I went to a liberal arts college in Western North Carolina called Warren Wilson because they had a program in old time music, and I went for 3 years, for 2 weeks a year. It was great. It was also more like banjo camp. But this one time at banjo camp, I was going along the path, and I heard this amazing banjo music, and I could have sworn it was my biggest hero, Richie Stearns, who's a great old-timey clawhammer player. But it wasn't Richie at all. It was a young woman. She was about 15 years old, and she was just playing the banjo like no tomorrow. And so I went up to her and I said, "Gee whiz, do you know who Richie Stearns is?" And she said, "Of course I do. He's my teacher." And I was blown away, and it was a young woman named Lydia Garrison, and we went on to become really good friends, and we have a group called the Turtle Ducks together, but she's also a great songwriter, and she wrote this song. It's a love song. It's called Burn. Thank you.
Leonard Podolak, ladies and gentlemen. So Leonard and I started the Ducks a long time ago, and shortly thereafter, our then guitarist Jordan McConnell's dad heard this great song on a Ruthie Foster record. It's called Death Came A-Knockin', and we recorded it on our self-titled record that we made here with Bela Fleck and Gary Pechoza. And we played in Denmark that year, and Ruthie's always been a big hero of mine, and she was at this festival in Denmark with us, and she got out and called us. She said, I heard there's this young group that does my song, so I think I'm gonna call them out. And she looks at me, I'm already like peeing my pants, and she looks at me and she's like, you wanna start it? And I was like, no. So she started it. But I guess age brings wisdom and confidence, and with the encouragement from my band, we're going to do this song now and ask Ruthie to come and join us on it. I just got chills when I said that. All right, we're gonna go somewhere else right now. Ridiculous human beings, seriously. Do you want to start this one? I'm just kidding. See what I did there?
Go, so I stood.
Foster, everyone.
Thank you so much. Wow.
We are the Ducks. Thanks so much for having us. We'll see you next time down the
Thank
road.
You.
We have some CDs over there. We'll be over there in a minute.
Thank you.
Thank you. Awesome. The Ducks.
Hey. Oh, man. It's always great to see you guys. I get to work with them very much. And the Ducks, let's hear it for them again. Well, Keith, is it time to draw the winner from Kirkland's Dream Room giveaway yet?
Jim, we just talked about that. That's next week.
Oh, right. Well,
I know.
That gives me time to call my cousin Tim and make sure he's all signed up.
Tim Lauderdale. Yeah, yes. We've got that one flagged. We'll.
Where?
Yeah. Where? You're not going to get away with it, Jim.
Darn.
It's a good idea, though. Folks, this week is the last week to enter the $1,000 Dream Room giveaway. Make sure to sign up at kirklands.com/roots. You want to be sure and do that because this is the tail end of the contest. Next Wednesday night, we draw the name. Folks, a big thanks to another one of our great sponsors tonight, the Star 129 Diamond. Some things only happen once in a lifetime, so the next time you have a special occasion, don't settle for ordinary. Take a look at the extraordinary Star 129 Diamond, guaranteed to come with the industry's highest VH Plus rating for scintillation, which is what we call the sparkle factor. You've really got to see it to believe it. If you're here in Nashville, stop in at Forster's Diamond Outlet on Hickory Hollow. See a comparison of the Star 129 next to an ordinary diamond. And while you're there, ask for a free pair of tickets to the Hippie Radio Groovin' and Cruisin' events next month. It's going to be a great time. I heard you can get a great price on those cool peace sign necklaces like Hippie Barb wears. You got on your necklace tonight? There you go. Yes, sir. Around the rest of the country, visit star129.com to learn more about the amazing Star 129 Diamond. Now it's time to go back to Craig. He's over in the chat room, sponsored by Griffin Technology, making it easier to connect to the music you love. Craig, before I turn it over to you,
sir.
I just want to mention we lost a great friend and a great man in country music yesterday, George Hamilton IV. Longtime member of the Grand Ole Opry, and gosh, I've listened to George Hamilton IV record so long. He introduced me to folks, the writers like Gordon Lightfoot and Joni Mitchell and John D. Loudermilk, and was just such a nice person.
Yeah,
too.
You were friends with him.
Our condolences to all his family, maybe listening in. George V and the 6th, uh-huh. George always said the 7th was up to the 6th.
There's,
as far as he
what
went.
A dynasty, my gosh. It's a family tradition.
Great person.
Well, let's hear it one more time for the Ducks, folks. This is Leonard Podolak and Jesse Havey. And y'all have been musical partners a long time. There's some great history here. It was about 2001 or 2 that this band was formed. There was a precursor. There was Scrooge McDuck. Was that just, were you both involved in that, or was that your... you were reconstructing? Yeah, what was the story of the origins of this union?
Well, really, the origins of the Ducks are really rooted in my parents' basement, where Jess's Uncle Marshall used to live. And I was in Scrooge McDuck, and I felt like I wanted to keep a connection with the new with the band that broke up, because we were just starting to make waves in the Canadian folk scene, and we'd done a couple festivals in the States, but then we broke up. So not to be defeated, I was wondering what I was going to do. But then Jess's uncle said, "Well, you ought to give Jess a call because she's a great singer." And I had absolutely nothing to lose at that point. And I've known Jess since she was a kid, and I was
really?
Just a little bit older.
And I had been a huge fan of his band. And I actually, my mom reminded me recently that when I was about 14, I wrote them a letter. The only piece of fan mail I've ever written, and said, "You guys are my favorite band. And I love Ruth Moody, the singer, now sings with the Whale and Jennies. But if she ever gets tired of it, I would love to be her singer." And it happened.
Yeah, so then I called her up, and we just started singing and playing together, and it worked really well right off the bat. And so I called a few other of my pals that I'd met down the road and knew that if we could all get along, that we'd make great music together.
of all these influences.
So that was, you know.
That's a great story. No, so of all these influences that we hear, was the old-time Appalachian the dominant, the Canadian folk specifically, a Celtic thing, or were you just as looking, you know, drawing at that point from
I think it was really the question of making a high-energy dance band for festivals. That,
all right.
Old-time music, Irish music, and Quebecois music, I think, were the sort of things I thought we'd draw from the most. But immediately once we started playing together, it became apparent and obvious that it was going to be a collaboration and a collection of five diverse musical tastes that were going to create the sound of the band.
Was a percussionist a critical decision to have one, and then that would have affected the way the band sounded fundamentally?
Yeah, well, when we got going, because I'd played in Scrooge, I wanted to have a percussion player, but I was completely ignorant of the percussive traditions, and I didn't know about Afro-Cuban music or African music or Middle Eastern music. All those drums that Kevin plays, each one of them has their own tradition rooted in the country that they come from, but I was completely ignorant. I just wanted someone who was going to make an eclectic sound that wasn't a drum kit.
Right on. Jesse, so talk about Winnipeg and the area there and what is distinctly Canadian about your band and your musical ideas.
Well, Winnipeg is an amazing epicenter for music and the arts in general in Canada. And Leonard's folks actually started the Winnipeg Folk Festival, which is world-renowned and wonderful. And so we both grew up there and sort of formed us as musicians, and also started a great sort of folk concert hall called the West End Cultural Center, and brought in all kinds of music from all over the world. My dad's from Nova Scotia, and okay. So I've got a bit of the Celtic-y, Cape Breton-y, and verging into Acadian and Cajun there. And then, yeah, I grew up, my family sang in choirs in the synagogue. And
okay.
Yeah.
Do you think that folk music has played a different role in Canadian life than American life? Or as you've toured, have you felt like there's a rather similar way in which they play a role?
Well, I think the only thing that's different about the role that exists or whatever it is in Canada and the States is that in Canada, the arts are funded by the government on many different levels. In the province of Manitoba, we have Manitoba Film and Music and Manitoba Music. And federally, there's FACTOR, which is Foundation to Assist Canadian Talent on Recordings, as well as the Canada Council for the Arts. And I can tell you that many of the artists that you've seen from Canada come down to the United States would not have possibly been able to do that and launch their career if it wasn't for funding. Festivals are funded. And the arts is something that's regarded as something that is vital to the survival of Canadian culture. And I think that is the same is true down here in the United States. And I encourage you to support people that support the arts, because without the arts, we are not full as people. And we can't deal without it. So it's a good, and not only that, but when the government does put money into the arts, it immediately gets circled back into the local communities. Right. Like, it isn't even something that is esoteric or out there. It's direct. The money comes directly back into the local economies right away. So it's not some kind of socialist plot.
You make me want to thank our sponsors yet again, because we feel like that's what we're asking them for, is to support artists and let this thing continue to grow and breathe and so forth. You draw from a lot of influences. Are there limits to eclecticism that you found? Are there times when you feel like too much salt, pepper, and cayenne? How has that shaped?
I don't feel like we put any limits on ourselves, and we just sort of, you know, people have asked us if we, sit down and come up with a concept when we're going to make a record, and we don't. We just play whatever it is that we're into right then, or new songs or whatever, and everybody, you know, it's a collective, and so everybody has their input, and yeah, we don't, there are no limits.
Right. Yeah, I would say really it's just the music that we like. I don't think there's much effort put into mixing these styles. You know, my body cannot get over a fiddle tune, whether it comes from Louisiana or Ireland or Nova Scotia or North Carolina. Right. To me, the groove and the beat and the rhythm, it just makes me want to move. And there's so much that's related in those styles that I don't think it's really much of a, I don't think it's really that eclectic, honestly.
Okay, fair enough. So the record, the new one is Beyond the Blue, and first one you've made as a team in quite some time. So talk about the feeling of getting that together and where the song, how easily the songs came and where they came from.
Well, we started, we put this group back together and we're doing some shows with the very original lineup. And then once we started touring more and deciding we wanted to do it again, other people had other priorities. And so we found a new group of whippersnappers and movers and shakers. And we didn't have a label. We made this one all on our own, actually funded, crowd funded by Indiegogo. Great. And our very dear friends, Mike and Ruthie, Mike Miranda and Ruth Unger, who used to have a band called The Mammals, who were on the circuit with Tao Rodriguez Seeger when we were coming up, and they were sort of our spouse band, we called them, and together we were Platypus, and they have a recording studio now in their house in West Hurley, New York, and so it's upstate in the woods, it's gorgeous, and they have two little kids running around, and we just made it with them because they share our musical sensibilities and our personal, they're just wonderful, they're our friends, they're our friends.
We didn't want to come to Nashville no matter what to make this record.
All right.
Nothing personal.
But we were also very lucky to have been sort of our friends at Compass Records, Gary West and Allison Brown, sort of took notice and went, hey, you know, guys, we could help you get this out there a little bit better. It might be a little bit easier than doing it all on your own.
How did they get to hear it?
We were very interested in signing the band in 2002, and we had the pen in our hand, and we wound up doing something else at the last second. But they've always been good friends, and I've always looked up to Allison Brown as a banjo player, and they've stuck with us, and they've been following our career sort of, you know, in this, I don't want to say the sidelines, because they're also at the very center of a lot of what's going on.
Yeah.
But from the side of us, anyway, they convinced us that it was a good idea to get involved with them, and we're excited to be working with them.
Before we even made the record, actually, we did a show together in Florida, a double bill, and they stood at the side and just watched, like, so intently the whole time, and I kept looking at Leonard like, look at them, look at Allison, Gary.
Yeah.
They're so into it. And right after, Leonard was like, so Gary started to, you know, see. And I was like, let's do it.
Okay.
We love those guys.
Right. They're screwing the last little bits in over here for BR, and we're just going to take a couple more seconds. Maybe I'll ask about Americana, because here we are celebrating that big, broad, you know, maelstrom of a format. And but you all have been everywhere I've gone that's had Americana over the door, especially Merlefest. You've been there and fitting beautifully in. Any feelings about?
Well, we sort of jokingly call ourselves Canadiana sometimes, but we also, I am of the belief that Americana is just a fancier way of saying folk music.
Sure. I'll buy that.
Right?
I agree with Jess. Honestly, I think you know, we play folk music, and we were sort of surprised to be called an Americana band. Honestly, not just because we're Canadian, but just because we play music from all over the place. But
very grateful to be embraced.
But yeah, Merlefest is a shining example of how the scene down here has embraced us. And even, you know, playing in the Americana conference, I think 3 or 4 times in the last 10 years has been
a
good sign of you know, the feeling that the scene has given us down here. And it's, you know, looking up, being on stage with our heroes and people that we once considered heroes and now our contemporaries and our friends is a massive honor that any five-string banjo picker could ever dream for. Playing with Doc.
Well, congratulations on being back in the new project, and we are grateful to have seen this early glimpse of what's going to be a very busy fall and winter, I'm sure.
Thank you so much. That was an amazing.
The Ducks, everybody.
Back.
Yeah. Thanks.
These guys never set out to be pioneers or to change the face of a city. They simply wanted to make country music in a way that tied the present moment to the legacy of their heroes, folks like Webb Pierce, Ernest Tubb, and Hank Williams. But an incredible story unfolded. They played 6 nights a week on Lower Broadway, building a scene and reviving Nashville's very heart. Then they took it national, releasing 6 albums while earning adulation and Grammy nominations. It's a rare treat to have the original lineup back together, and we can't say how excited we are to have them here. Put your hands together for BR549.
I got me a room in a cheap hotel. My head was spinning and I didn't feel well. I laid right down and I tried to go
laying and shaking my bed. Honky tonk, all night long. Honky tonk, same old song. Honky tonk, my money's all gone. Honky tonk, she done me wrong. I turned and I tossed, but I couldn't go to sleep, 'cause the band kept a-playing with the honky tonk. Shaking my bed.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for all the way from Lawrence, Kansas, my good friend, Mr. Chuck Mead, right here.
All right. All ready. Betty, Betty, where can you be? I ain't seen the likes of you in Hustler magazine. Betty, Betty, don't you understand? If I had been taught by you, I'd be a different man. You came to New York City back in Jack and Neil's day. All the lights of old Times Square, they flickered on the Great White Way. Straight from Tennessee and in the rarest beauty form, you walked before the claw and caused a nationwide. If I had been taught by you, I'd be a different man. Brawl, but they don't see your smile like I do, shining in my dream. That jungle mistress, dark Madonna, leather movie queen. Betty, Betty, where can you be? I ain't seen the likes of you in Hustler magazine. Betty, Betty, don't you understand? If I had been taught by you,
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. How about a nice round of applause for my good buddy all the way from Cougar, Washington, USA, Mr. Gary Bennett. Come on.
Here's the oldest song we know. Everybody, and would you please put your hands together right now for our good buddy back here on the fiddle and the steel guitar, Mr. Don Heron.
Gone, he'll be enough.
and dancing, still out there. The bodies all piled up high. She used to park in the pit with the best of them. Please don't ask me why. But I'm drinking blue ribbon and jitterbugging to that honky tonky beat. Whoa, get that line dance out of him, man. Give her room to move her feet. She done traded in a dock for kicker boots. Said to be a teacher for Manuel. Her hair's grown out and it's piled up high. She only shows her tattoos one at a time. She ain't ashamed of the way she was. She hears old things she can't get enough. A punk rock record to gather in dust. Cause little Ramona's gone hillbilly nuts. In the mall. She acts just as tough as she always did. She just looks a little country, that's all. She got Emmy Lou, Patti Smith on a 9-minute cassette. Cause so where do you go through the end of the world when you still ain't been there yet? She done traded in a dock for kicker boots. Said to be a teacher for man wears suits. Her head's grown out and it's piled up high. She only shows her tattoos one at a time. She ain't ashamed of the way she was. She hears old things she can't get enough. A punk rock record to gather in dust. Cause little Ramona's gone, he'll be the nuts. But little Ramona's gone, he'll be the nuts.
I think they got a dancing license in this place if you feel the urge. And we definitely have a tip jar up here. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome all the way from West Lafayette, Indiana. He's only 15 years old, Mr. Smiling Jay McDowell on the Doghouse bass.
Yeah, you're the prettiest thing I've ever seen.
last for me. What a nice bunch of people. Thank you. And with you one more time, put your hands together for our friend back all the way from, well, now he's from Lawrence, Kansas, and now he's in Arizona, Mr. Shaw Wilson, back on the drums. Give it up for Shaw.
My pockets are empty, though my wife will send me to the store for some cigarettes and bread. I started walking there, got as far as the square, then the smell of beer went to my head. The thing about beer, it can make a man hear voices from days long since past. And with every third drink, it make you think that your youth will always last. No matter which way you move, it takes a lifetime to prove to yourself I could have been more. I got 1 foot in the door, I just want one more. I thought of a time when the future was mine, it didn't matter what anyone said. I was handsome and strong when I walked along. I stood erect and looked straight ahead. Then I lost my fight going to tournament. Somewhere along the line I lost my will. Now I'm sitting here, my life full of fear, and I try to pretend it's not real. No matter which way you move, it takes a lifetime to prove to yourself I've been there before. I got 1 foot in the door, I just want one more. These days I barely survive on lot number 5 in the Mobile Acres on the east side of town. I swore this kind of life I'd never leave. I guess I let too many things get me down. If my pappy could see what they'd done to me, I'd swear he'd march down there and make it all right. But he's long since gone and I'm old enough now, I should be able to fight my own fight. No matter which way you move, it takes a lifetime to prove to yourself I could have been more. I got 1 foot in the door, I just want one more. I got 1 foot in the door, I just want one more.
Thank you.
Start all over again. 'Cause my
tight. I'll say you were right and I was wrong. Cause my cupboards are bare and I ain't got no clothes to wear. And it feels like I'm going insane. Well, he says it's nice outside, but the weatherman is never right. In my world, it's pouring past. Yes, in my world, it's pouring past.
It's not 12 midnight at all yet. Usually we reserve this song for after midnight. It's the true story of the lost episode of the Andy Griffith Show, ladies and gentlemen. Well, Goober brought down some homegrown hay and want me up beside the head. I never felt that way. I ain't be said we'd be in Dutch if the sheriff ever caught us smoking that stuff. Don't tell, Andy, don't tell, ain't be. They won't come and looking for Opie and me. Tell them we're dead or tell them we're gone. Me and Opie down by the duck pond. Well, I heard a little holler down in the woods. Sounded like a someone saying, mm-mm, good. I move a little closer, sneaking just like a squirrel. Otis was slurping up his favorite girl. Well, now Otis said, boys, come sit by the still. I pour you up a jar of that famous swill. If you can't walk, don't worry, no way. Light that pipe and pass it my way. And don't tell, Andy, don't tell, ain't me. They won't come looking for Opie and me. Swamp came Ernest T. Go to flashing as he hit that pipe. Out of the blue came Barney Fife. Well, now Barney come down to nip that still. Waving an axe, a lawman's thrill. Oh, don't smoke, you'll turn yourself green. Give me up a puff and I'll show you what I mean. Don't tell, Andy, don't tell, ain't me. They were coming looking for Opie and me. Down by the duck pond. That's a true story. I know what kind of people we're in here with tonight.
Oh, this just in.
It's on hippie. Oh, look at
Thank
that.
Thank you.
Thank you for your nice contribution. You're going to heaven.
Way back in the woods, we were five people doing good. But a podunk town can get too small, and I knew someday I'd hit the wall. Than this.
beeline down that old dirt road till I found myself in a place I didn't know. There were people everywhere and it looked suspicious to me, and me to them as far as I could see. And I saw some things that were too hard to resist. I thought, man, there can be nothing better than this. So let me go, I gotta get moving, I'm taking a ride. Don't I know the grass always looks greener on the other side. As the voice is getting louder, this place is I'm a woman.
He does the Indian boogie to a white man's song, singing, hey ho, Alina,
hey ho, Alina,
hey ho, Alina,
hey ho, Alina,
I'm singing, hey ho, Alina, whoop whoop with the lie, hey. Well, he dances over here and he dances over there and he dances with the woman called the standing bear. Now, hey ho, Alina,
hey ho, Alina,
hey ho, Alina,
hey ho, Alina,
I'm singing, hey ho, Alina, whoop whoop with the lie, hey. Dances on the rock, my buddy, keep on shaking that old Tommy hop now. Hey ho, Alina.
Hey ho, Alina.
Hey ho, Alina.
Hey ho, Alina.
Singing, hey ho, Alina. Whoop whoop with tonight. Hey. Well, he's shaking to the hills and he's shaking to the clouds and he's talking, talking, being so big and proud now. Hey ho, Alina.
Hey ho, Alina.
Hey ho, Alina.
Hey ho, Alina.
Hey, ho, Alina. Singing, hey ho, Alina. Whoop whoop with tonight. Hey. Tonight, hey. Well, a Cherokee chief as he dances along does the Indian boogie to a white man's song. Hey ho, Alina.
Hey ho, Alina.
Paulina, whoop up with the nine.
Can we do a couple more? All right, they're letting us play a little bit longer. God bless. Thank you, everybody, at the Music City Roots Show. Everybody is very nice. Thank you for having us.
Day comes along, sometimes I gotta do something, even if it's wrong. The telephone keeps ringing and it gets under my skin. They all call to ask me when I'll send the money in. But AT&T does a favor for me and takes a message at the tone. Sometimes you gotta do something, even if it's wrong. Seems the road is getting rougher as I roll on up the hill. Hot time's passing by me just like I was standing still. But I'm almost to the top and I'll go until I drop. Some fall by the wayside, but I've gone too far to stop. A woman of my dreams, she was like a living doll. I sent her far away when she set me for. She was a digger and the bills got bigger and I was up against the wall. Sometimes you gotta do something, even if it's wrong. Now I hear those wolves a-howling and I can't get no sleep at all. The good Lord knows I'm tired of robbing Peter to pay Paul. But the grindstone to the gravestone, is it really worth it all? Sometimes you gotta do something, even if it's wrong. Seems the road is getting rougher as I roll on up the hill. Hot time's passing by me just like I was standing still. But I'm almost to the top and I'll go until I drop. Some fall by the wayside, but I've gone too far to stop.
I think we have a whole lot of CDs and stuff for sale over there if anybody is interested in that. It's a bunch of old stuff and a bunch of weird stuff that you never heard before that Jay compiled. We're going to do one more song, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, it's a Death Trucker song.
Right.
A young man's dream. Been head pencil pushing loud mouth geek. Cut me off at my marker 33. I'm ready to pay for the movie made with his pencil and a fiery grave. 18 wheels and a crowbar. I'm cutting you down to size. 18 wheels and a crowbar. Can't run away this time. 18 wheels and a crowbar, I'm gonna put the hammer down. 18 wheels and a crowbar, fate was on the dashboard looking right at me now.
a foggy night. That bile in my stomach don't taste quite right. Three men in a Mercedes Benz got wrapped around a telephone pole. Don't know my 20 and my eyelids shut. I fall down and I can't get up. Driving blind just in time to lay to rest your weary soul. 18 wheels and a crowbar cutting you down to sight. 18 wheels and a crowbar can't run away this time. 18 wheels and a crowbar, I'm gonna put the hammer down. 18 wheels and a crowbar, it was on the dashboard looking right at me now. Pay the human toll. 18 wheels and a crowbar cutting you down the side. 18 wheels and a crowbar can't run away this time. 18 wheels and a crowbar, I'm gonna put the hammer down. 18 wheels and a crowbar, they was on the dashboard looking right at me now.
Thank you.
BR549.
Thank you, everybody. God bless you.
Let's hear it for him. BR549, everybody. Woo! Thank you, guys. It's amazing. Thank you so much. Keith?
Yes, sir. Wasn't that great? Congratulations to our friends at the Nashville Conservancy who are celebrating the launch of their new campaign tonight. If Trees Could Sing, go to the Music City Roots face page to see one of the videos by our own Jim Lauderdale talking to and about his favorite tree. He talks to trees a lot, actually. You're listening to Nashville's Hippie Radio, WHPY, Bellevue, Nashville, 94.5. And speaking of people that care about our environment, what about that beautiful 100% electric Nissan Leaf over there? Isn't that nice? Yeah. I asked for the keys earlier, and I still haven't gotten them. They said they'd get them to me, though. So far, 55,000 customers in the United States are saving a lot of money at gas stations and enjoying lower maintenance costs. Every new Nissan Leaf in the United States comes from right here in Tennessee. The vehicle and battery plant are located in Smyrna, just a short drive from here. Now, trust me, if you really need to drive one, it's going to shock you. And it's going to be seating for five so the whole family can come along. And currently, if you buy a new Nissan Leaf here in Nashville, Nissan's no charge to charge promotion provides you complimentary access to public charging stations for 2 full years. Talk about range confidence. So visit your local Nashville dealer today and test drive the 100% electric, no gas Nissan Leaf. Nissan, Nashville proud. By the way, thanks to Griffin Technology for the phone charging station up in Sponsors Village. Here's Craig in the Griffin chat room. How about it, Craig?
Thanks, Steve. What a good time.
Yeah.
By the way, you know what? Cars don't have keys anymore.
Oh,
you just
right.
get in. They just know you're there.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
What is it they call that thing that you lay up there when you push the button? It's got a name, and I don't remember what it is.
I don't even know. But it just knows. It's great. Folks, thanks for coming out tonight. We got the Nashville Jam coming up here. Those of you who are in the know not to leave your seats. We got one more song coming up. Everybody's going to have their way with it. Boy, what a good time. The Blackstone Brewery lineup tonight was awesome. BR549, the Ducks, Ruthie Foster, Chris Smither. Let's give them all a big hand.
Good stuff.
Thank you, everybody. You can see BR549 again on Saturday at noon, I believe. Is it noon? 2 o'clock. 2 o'clock at the Country Music Hall of Fame. They're going to be doing an afternoon of programming dedicated to the legacy of Lower Broadway with Greg Gehring and R.B. Morris and some of the heroes that helped make Lower Broadway hum again in the 1990s and set the stage for this incredible growth and renaissance we've seen in Nashville. On top next week here on our stage, we have a season closer, and we have a very interesting combination. On one hand, we're going to be welcoming back our friends from Australia. Dobe Newton has lined up some leading talent out of Australia. They're all in for the convention. And we're going to be hearing from the May Trio, from Brooke Russell and the Mean Reds, Falls, a band called Falls, and Kevin Bennett. And then to cap things off, a special set celebrating the release of a brand new album that is absolutely just stunning, the great and historic Mac Wiseman will be here. I know Myra is going to be in the front row. And just as they get finished here, let me just point out that we've got sprawling, unbelievable entertainment and talent around town over the next few nights. There's stuff starting, even going on right now. You could get back into town and see things. But a lot of Music City Roots alums. Tomorrow night, those include Chatham County Line, Susie Boggess, Hayes Carl, the Howland Brothers, Jim Oblon, Cale Tyson, the Quaby Sisters, and some guy named Jim Lauderdale.
Whoa.
Then on Saturday, well, you can go find Paul Birch, Liz Longley, Bradford Lee Folk, Los Colones, the Deadly Gentlemen, Blackie and the Rodeo Kings, the Steep Canyon Rangers, New Country Rehab, and Chuck Mead doing a set with his Grassy Knoll Boys. So get your wristband and go and see and hear and just take in the magnificence that is today's Americana music scene. It's so good to have the association right here at the factory in Franklin. That's their headquarters, about 50 feet from where we're sitting. And we know how hard they've worked to put this thing on, and they're going full guns 20 hours a day. And I'm having a great time already.
Busy trying to get things situated. What festival were you just talking about? In all seriousness, which one?
Louder Fest. In the midst of, you know, it's officially called the Americana Music Association.
Oh, this
conference and festival.
Yes, absolutely.
That's what it
okay.
is. Or as Sam Bush said, "Who's been at the festival all 3 days?" Yeah, it's happening.
Guys, you remember when we were over in Belfast when we took?
I'm not done yet.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
It's okay. I'm going to give it back to you in a minute.
He said so much before.
I know. Well, I want to remind you that we are all crazy about the Nashville Jam. Gary and Courtney Brown started making their gourmet jams and jellies as gifts for family and friends from the abundance of their own garden. And now though it's in stores from New York to Texas, it's still made that same loving care, handmade, all natural way. Gourmet jams and jellies from natural fruit flavors like strawberry and blueberry to wild tastes like peach, habanero, and garlic and Vidalia onion. It's served proudly in finer restaurants like the Omni downtown, available at fine grocers like Kroger. We're proud to introduce you to Nashville Jams. By the way, Monday night, Peter Cooper and I are sitting down in the living room with Mac Wiseman and having a good old talk on Hippie Radio, on the Roots Radio Hour. Be sure and join us at 7 o'clock. You're going to enjoy it. Let me tell you, Mac is 89 years old. He's so sharp and so funny, and still sing so great. So be sure and listen for that on Hippie Radio this coming Monday night. And now, I want to take you back to center stage, a man that I admire so much. He is a great singer. He's a great songwriter. He's going to tell you a story about Belfast, Northern Ireland. I have no idea what that's all about. But would you make welcome Jim Lauderdale. There he is.
Well, thank you. Thanks a lot, Keith. And folks, thanks so much for coming out tonight. Have you had a good time here at Music City Roots? We hope you'll come back frequently. Tell your friends about it. And, you know, we got to go over to Belfast and take Music City Roots over there last March. And I made a great friend over there, and he's a very fine young man, Michael Weir. Michael, stand up, wave to everybody. He is a terrific young man, and I'm just so glad that he and his family are here for Americana. Are you enjoying the Americana Festival? Good, good. This is great that you're here, Michael. Well, this one's for you and your family. You know, it was Hank Williams Sr.'s birthday yesterday. And so we're going to send this song out to his memory and to Michael and his family. And thank all y'all again for coming out. And here we go.
I wandered so aimless, my life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light. I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man, I wandered along. Worries and fears I claimed for my own. Then, like the blind man, God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
I saw the light. I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. I'm so happy, sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Oh, Donnie, come on.
So aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside.
Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
see you next week here on Music City Roots.
Some of our out-of-town artists and guests stay courtesy of the beautiful Magnuson Hotel in Cool Springs, minutes from downtown Nashville, offering all the right amenities. It's a great choice for your next visit to Music City. Go to MagnusonHotels.com for reservations. Music City Roots is a production of Hang Dye Media. Executive producers John Walker and Todd Mayo would like to wish happy birthdays this week to associate producer Conrad Custer and social media guy Dylan Crane and many more. Fellas, thanks for all your hard work. And of course, a big thanks to all our friends at Hippie Radio. Don't forget to join me for the Roots Radio Hour weekdays at 7 p.m. where we'll explore the roots of Americana and rock for fun for hippies of all ages. Hippie Radio 94.5 on your FM dial. We're glad you joined us this week for Music City Roots. Live from the factory, I'm Keith Bilbrand from the edge of Music City. Good night, everybody.
Hang tight.